Tune into this week's On.NET, where I have my good friend John Dick on, team lead of .NET MAUI, talking about how to use the Windows subsystem from Android from Visual Studio in one click. So tune in. Welcome back, everyone, to another On.NET. I'm your host, James Montemagno, and this week I have my good friend, John Dick, on. There he is. How's it going, buddy?
Hey, good. How about you?
I am doing absolutely amazing, and mostly because I get to talk to you, which I don't often get to do, but also because you are talking about the Windows subsystem for Android, which is like my favorite thing in Windows 11.
Yeah, it's been really cool to watch that kind of grow. Like, I got to play with it pretty early on and make sure, you know, all the bits worked with the Xamarin bits and the MAUI bits, and a lot of fun seeing it evolve and like just using it as like an actual daily kind of debug target. It's great.
Yeah. Can you kind of describe like the importance of WSA, as we'll call it, and like why developers care about it? Because obviously consumers, you can like run Android apps on your Windows machine, but yeah. Why do developers care?
Yeah, I mean, like, because it's Android on your Windows machine, it really is like having your Windows machine be an Android device. And from a developer perspective, that means that you get to target that device, which is your big desktop or big laptop or whatever that has lots of CPU in it, and run your applications there. And so, you know, one of the big wins is obviously like as a developer, the dev loop time, the time to like build and deploy and run these things on your machine is a lot quicker, especially if you've got some pretty, you know, decent hardware, which, I mean, most computers are a little bit more powerful than your Android devices these days, hopefully. So that's, you know, a big part of it. And then the other part is because now we have these customers and these people using apps in the stores. I mean, I want my app to be there if it's possible for it to run there, right? Like, it's another whole audience.
Yeah, super great, because if you were only deploying just like iOS and Android, you could basically for zero work bring your Android app into the Windows Store. Of course, with .NET MAUI, right? And WinUI 3 and things like this, you can build with native Windows applications. But if you're not there yet, you can put it in the store and you can always upgrade over time, which is really cool.
Yeah, it gives you a new opportunity to target that platform. And like, even if you've got a MAUI app or you've got a Xamarin app, I mean, maybe you originally targeted Android and iOS. And, you know, that's a great starting point as you kind of onboard things over to Windows as a platform.
Yeah. Now, you've been tinkering around with a lot of tooling. You've been into a lot of stuff. So you built the MAUI check early in the days of .NET MAUI. Still a thing, I think. And then, you know, I think that you and I have always talked about WSA in the terms of, wow, this thing is amazing for developers, but it could be simpler, right? So what are the issues that you see with just developers getting up and running with WSA?
Yeah, so the hardest part is really just getting it to a point where you can see it in Visual Studio, right? So if you're a MAUI developer, a Xamarin developer, like this is a MAUI app. This is the new cool stuff, single project MAUI app, right? So I'm targeting Android, but, you know, I've got my emulators to choose from and yeah. I've got Pixel 4 hooked up to my computer. But to actually go now and get subsystem for Android showing up in that menu, it's like, well, OK, there's a few steps to do that if you're going to do that just out of the box. So the first step would be go to the store and download and install the subsystem for Android. Once you've done that, you know, you can go into the settings here. This is kind of newer. It didn't used to exist, but there's a nice developer section here and you can go enable developer mode. And then once you do that, you can start the subsystem by like clicking the developer settings. Alternatively, you can launch like the App Store app and that'll start up the subsystem. But if you haven't changed things from like the default settings here, like there's the default here is subsystem resources as needed. And that basically means run the thing when I need it to run. Otherwise, you know, if I'm not doing anything with it, if it's idle, just like shut it down because I want to use those resources on my machine for other things.
Got it.
So if you do it that way, if you want to conserve resources, every time you want to go back and use this thing, you've got to go start it up. And then the other part of this, which they don't really show you how to do here anywhere. I think there's some docs if you like link through to some of these documentation links. But what you would need to do is start it up, and then go get the IP address, or, you know, there's kind of a simpler shortcut, which is this IP address of your local host and then this special port that you can enter. But you got to go there into ADB Connect and enter that in. And if you're like a Xamarin developer, maybe you never set up your path variable to have like the ADB on it, right? So then you're like, oh, where is that thing? I start typing it in and I can't find it. So I, funny enough, did these steps for months and months of use at a time. And finally, the other day, I'm just like, you know what? I had a bunch of the code written to do the work to like start the thing up, to wait for it to be started, right? Because you want to like start launching it, but you need to know when it's ready to actually connect to, and then to actually go ahead and do the connection through ADB.
Oh, cool.
So that's where we get to this thing.
Nice. So you built something to get rid of all of those manual steps. You've automated the process is what I'm hearing for developers.
For the most part. I mean, this is a really kind of silly, simple extension that I made, but hey, it kind of does the job. You could probably do it with like, you know, a bash script, or I guess a PowerShell script on Windows. But so I made this extension. You go install it. You go to the tools menu once it's installed in your Visual Studio instance. And you can see here, there's this, you know, unassuming menu entry now, Windows for Android.
Okay. So this is your, so you get it from the store, you install it, and it's one click is what you're saying here.
One click.
It is very ominous. So, it's like, okay, what is this going to do? I don't know what it's going to do. I like that you made it ominous. It's like a mystery. It's a mystery button.
Yeah. Yeah. It's like subsystem for Android. I think I want that. I probably want that. I should probably click it.
It sounds good. Yeah. Click it. What happens?
So let's see if we click it. So first of all, it's going to say like, hey, the developer mode needs to be enabled. I can't tell that it's enabled yet. And that's kind of a whole technical detail that I'm not going to get into. But hey, do we want to enable it? And I think so, right? Let's do it. It is going to elevate prompt you, because it does have to write a registry entry into the local system registry. So that's what it's doing.
Got it.
Promise. But now you can see here, it's showing, hey, Windows subsystem for Android is initializing.
Oh, cool.
We've even got the nice little task in here. And then, whoa, boom.
Wow. Right? Wow. You really, really hit the extension points. Mads would be proud.
You know what? I used the new extension stuff too.
Oh, wow.
It's beautiful.
Wow.
That's what made this whole part easy, because I didn't know how to do this before. And I'm looking. I'm like, well, I have, you know, the VS dot, and then I've got all the toys and options from there to use. So.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. So that shows up as enabled. Great. Click that away. And so now, when we look at our local devices, we had the Pixel 4 before, but look at this.
Whoa. The very Microsoft name, Microsoft Corporation Subsystem for Android TM.
Yeah. And so you can even see now the problem that comes with that name, right? Yeah. So I've talked to the team recently, the tooling team, about like, hey, like, you know, this is how we kind of show things in here, but maybe we need to at least shorten it up once it hits like this button area, right?
Yeah.
So look for that in future versions. We'll get that fixed up.
But if you're on a widescreen like me, then it's not a problem. So
I'm on a low resolution for the recording right now. So like that's when you hit it. But like normally it's in there. It's fine. It's great.
That's awesome.
This is what we can use now, right? Should we do it?
Yeah, do it. I'm ready. That was crazy quick. You didn't have to go find anything. You didn't have to go do anything. It just like did it.
Yeah. And now we're deploying, right? Deploying to that.
And this is so the core, like you said earlier, like this is running on your Windows machine. There's no emulator, no simulator. It's running on the subsystem, right?
Yeah. And like it's a window, right? So like I can resize it. I can do all sorts of crazy stuff like that. I can make it bigger, taller. And then like it's Android, but it's on my machine. In our title bar, we've got like the back button there, right? For Android, which is cool.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, I mean, this is the app. And it does all the things too, right? Like it does the... You know, it does the C# hot reload. Oh, now I got to find the button. So I'm going to change that to increment that counter by 2. And that's pretty cool, because now we can just boom.
Nice.
Just simple.
And you can have breakpoints and everything like that. And everything
breakpoints.
Like,
we've got the, we got the XAML hot reload, which is always fun, right? Hello, Android. Well, I guess it's subsystem for Android. You can hit breakpoints. I could go into here now and say like, oh, yeah, I actually want to pause when that happens. So this is cool, right? And we talked about the whole value of like development loop here too. So if I go and close this, and I'm gonna go make a change, and let's say I didn't have hot reload, even though I do, I'm gonna change that. I saved it. I'm gonna compile it again. And I don't know if you, you know, remember kind of how long this takes usually with an emulator. Or even like a physical Android device, right? Like it's to do the part after the compiling where it installs to the time it launches, it can take a little bit of time. So like this is a nice, faster way to do it.
Yeah, it's super nice. Still. I mean, there's no additional, there's not like a layer upon a layer upon a layer. It's just there.
Yeah, and these will even show up in like your, if I go here, like it shows up as an installed app, right, on Windows with the subsystem. So that's kind of cool too.
Yeah, so you get all that goodness for free. Now, I'll put links, of course, to the extension in the show notes below. But John, this is amazing. You solved all my problems.
Just a little helper, make things a little bit easier. Let's all develop a little bit faster.
I love it. It's small things like that that bring so much joy to my face and to my life and to my development life. So, John, thank you so much for coming on, showing it off.
Thanks for having me. It's always fun.
Awesome. Well, I will put show links to everything that John showed below. And of course, if you're over on YouTube, don't forget to jam that like button and hit that subscribe button as well, so you get notified every time we put out a new live stream or video right here on YouTube. But that's going to do it for this week's On.NET. Huge shout out to the .NET MAUI team and John Dick and everybody in the community for the huge launch of it into GA. I'll put links to that in the show notes below as well. So that's going to do it for this week's On.NET. So until next time, I'm James, and this has been On.NET.